You're watching CNA Heroes. Here's Lisa Sweet.
Welcome to CNA Heroes. I'm Lisa Sweet, co-founder of the National Association of Healthcare Assistants, or NACA. Ask any CNA about their work and they'll tell you how difficult it is, both physically and emotionally. Given the pandemic of the past year, the work has become even more challenging. To work as a CNA is very admirable, but to do it for decades is heroic. Thank you to the Daily Reporter out of Spencer, Iowa, for initially publishing this story. Longhouse Northshire is a long-term care community in Spencer, Iowa. They are extremely fortunate and grateful to have two CNAs with a combined 85 years of consecutive employment at the home. Connie Poulin, CNA, is celebrating 40 years of service at Longhouse Northshire. Her father, Ira Garvis of Ira's Barbershop, used to cut hair at the nursing home in 1980, and he asked if there were any job openings for his daughter. After filling out an application, she was hired right away. Following 9 years in the kitchen, she became a CNA in 1989. All you do is make sure the residents are safe and taken good care of, Connie said. I'm here to take care of someone that needs tender, loving care, and they all know that I'm here and they appreciate it. Colleen Conrad, CNA, celebrating 45 years, started working as a nursing assistant at LHNS right out of high school. With prior work experience in a nursing home, she moved from Lawrence to Spencer in 1976 and has been a CNA at the nursing home ever since. The one-to-one with the residents, hearing their stories and talking with them are what Colleen loves about her job. Colleen states, with some of the things you do with the residents, you're able to interact a little more and say, oh, I got sweet corn last night. Did you guys go out and pick sweet corn? And try to relate back to their stories about their youth or growing up. She continues, you get some pretty interesting stories. They always say you should write a book about all those stories. I wouldn't even know where to begin, she concludes. Being able to provide residents comfort, as well as being a friend to them, is important to both Connie and Colleen. Colleen remarks that you go home with a sense of pride and accomplishment when you have actually gotten to get a resident to do something like walk down the hall a little further that day, so you know you are improving their life by keeping them more mobile. Even visiting them because they're sad, then you find out that something tragic happened and you give them a little comfort. That makes you feel better about yourself, she said. Both women enjoy their work at LHNS alongside their friends and coworkers. Connie said she's going to continue to work for as long as she's able. She said she's only 57, so she still has a few years left to go. She said her goal is to work until she can't work anymore. Colleen, on the other hand, will be 64 soon and is looking forward to her retirement. She explains, starting as young as I did, we didn't have lifts like we do now. We used three or four people to lift many residents out of bed. Now you take one of these lifts and two of you can do it and it's not hard on your body. The body kind of goes after a while, but it hasn't gone enough that it's made me want to quit yet, but it's coming. Connie Poulin and Colleen Conrad, the decades of caring each of you have so generously delivered are invaluable. Your commitment and dedication are inspiring, and we here at NACA know that you have helped so many frail and elderly live their best days possible. Thank you for your service. Everyone, please join us in recognizing two extraordinary CNAs, Connie Poulin and Colleen Conrad, CNA heroes.